Hello everyone, welcome back. Welcome to LRDA Prep. My name is Sameer Sardana and we are discussing this 100 muscle reasoning questions for SNAP. And here in this video lesson, I will be discussing one set of input output. As you know that this is one of the type of questions that you might come across in SNAP exam. It was asked recently also in the SNAP exam which was conducted recently. So let's have a look at this set. You see that here, these are the standard instruction that one, when a word and number arrangement machine is given an output, a line of words and numbers, it arranges them. So basically what we are supposed to do is we are supposed to find out the rules of the arrangement. That's the main purpose of solving the input output, rules of arrangement of words and numbers is what we are supposed to find out to solve the question of input output. Once you know the rules of arrangement, that's it, the set can be completely can be solved easily. And then I'll be telling the shortcut of ranking method, which helps you in solving the questions quickly, because using the ranking method, you will not be writing down all the steps. If you are not writing down all the steps, that will save your time a lot. So now you see that first, let's find out what are the rules of arrangement of the words and the numbers. You see that this is my input, which is having different words starting with the alphabets E, M, F, right, S, R, J, and then you also have some numbers 30, 41, 52, 61, 36, 89. Look at the rules of the arrangement. In the first step, you see that two words with the smallest alphabet E and F, smallest alphabet which are among the available words, the two smallest alphabets are E and F. So these are the words which are starting with smallest alphabet and they are arranged at first position and the second position. And in step two, you see that the largest number 89 and the second largest number 61 have been positioned after these two alphabets, after these two words. And then in the third step, the third largest alphabet J and the fourth largest alphabet M. Why third largest A? Because you see that after E and F, the next largest alphabet which is available among these words are J and M. So you are arranging the words starting with letter J and the words starting with the letter M. And then in next step, the next number, which is smaller than 61, but highest among all the remaining numbers is 52. So in the next step four, 51 and 41 have been positioned. And then in next, the next largest alphabet, that is R, and the word starting with R, alphabet R, and the word starting with S has been placed. And then the last two numbers, the smallest number, 36 and 30 are placed in the last step. And this is our final output. So you see that the purpose of this machine is to arrange the words in the increasing order, right? And the numbers in the decreasing order. And what are the rules of arrangement? The rules of arrangement says two elements are supposed to be moved in one step. Ek step ke andar do elements ko move karna hai. And first words will be moving and then numbers will be moving. So word numbers will move alternatively, and you see that final arrangement that you're looking for is to arrange the words in the increasing order and to arrange the numbers in the decreasing order. First words will be arranged in one step and then numbers will be arranged in the next step, right? So these are the rules of arrangement that we need to apply. Now once you find out the rules of the arrangement in the input, all you have to do is design a ranking method in your mind. See that the elements are supposed to move on the left side. So what you need to know here is the rules of arrangement will design a strategy for the ranking also. There's one more thing in the rules of arrangement that you need to note down, that two elements in the increasing order of alphabets are supposed to be arranged with words and numbers, and elements are moving on the left hand side. Right, elements are moving on the left hand side. Left hand side means you see that you're picking the words and the numbers and putting it on the left hand side, right? For example, E and F were taken to be the leftmost position of this complete arrangement, and then after that 89 and 61 were taken and put on the left hand side, right? So this is how the arrangement is being done. Now you need to do the ranking. You see that in the first step, the two elements which will be moving will be ranked as 1A and 1B. Now ranking them 1A and 1B tell me that these are the two elements which are moving in the first step to the leftmost position. For example, in this particular input, the smallest word, the word with the smallest alphabet is is this particular word alluring, which is starting with the letter A and the second is L, and then you see this word is also starting with A and the second alphabet as N. So if I have to arrange them, you see this has to be 1A and this has to be 1B, right? Now after arranging these two words, the next, in the second step, I'm supposed to take the numbers on the left hand side. Second step mein aapko numbers ko left hand side pe leke ja raha hai. So second step mein aap numbers ki ranking karoge. So second rank mein, you see that 81 is the element which will be moving on the left hand side. But this number, the largest number, will be moved in the second step. So this will be ranked as 2A, right? After 81, the next alphabet, the largest alphabet is 49. So this will be 2B, right? And then after arranging AN, and A N A L A N, and then after, then the next alphabet you can see is born, right? The next alphabet is the letter B. So this will be moved in the third step, but you see that this will be automatically positioned at its own position because there is no element which is positioned on the left hand side of the word born. Or you can simply write it down as 3A. And then after B, the next alphabet that will be coming will be enough, and this is 3B, right? So in third step, this is the first element which will be positioned, and this will be the next element that will be positioned. Now there, it will be the turn of number. The next number is 47, so this will be ranked as 4A. And after 47, the next alphabet is 25, so this is 4B, right? Once you position these two elements as 4A and 4B, in the next step, you need to rank the words with the largest alphabet. So A, B, C, and then finally you can see that the next largest alphabet is M, right? So this will be 5A, and after M, the next would be S, so this will be 5B. And you see that 16, the next largest number 16 would be arranged in the sixth step, and this will be arranged in the sixth B step, right? That means in the sixth step, two elements will be moving. First will be 16 and the next will be 11. So you see that this complete arrangement will be done in six steps, right? Now I can answer all these questions. I see that the ranking method will help me in reducing the number of steps. I don't need to write down all the steps, right? This helps in saving time. Moreover, if input is getting changed in every question, I don't need to write down all the steps to answer it. I can simply use the ranking method to answer all my questions. Look at this question number 7. Question number 7 says, which of the following term exactly come between 49 and enough in step 3? Now see that in step 3, you will have 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, 3A and 3B. These are the elements which will be arranged till the step 3. Rest of the elements will be positioned at their own position without doing any arrangement, because in step 3 these are the elements which will be at their position, right? Now I'm supposed to tell the number of terms, the term which will be coming exactly between 49 and enough. Now let's see which rank is 49. Now 49, you see, is ranked as 2B and enough is ranked as 3B. 2B and 3B, right? So this is 49 and this is enough, right? Let's see that in 49 and enough, the word that will be coming in between, or which will be coming exact, which will come exactly between 49 and enough, is the number or the letter or the word with ranking as 3A. Now all you have to do is just check out the number which is having a rank of 3A. The rank of 3A is given to the word born. So therefore, the answer to the question is option number D. You don't need to write down step 1, step 2 and step 3 to answer this question. You see that if I'm supposed to answer this question, I don't need to write down step 1 and step 2 and step 3. I can simply answer this question by doing the ranking once, and then all the 5 questions can be easily solved. How many elements are there between 25 and 16 step 5? Now see that in step 5, you'll have 1A. You will have 2A, sorry, 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, 3A, 3B, 4A, 4B, 5A and 5B. This is my fifth step. Rest of the elements will be placed at its own position. Now we have to see what's the rank of 25 and 16. Rank of 25, guys, check. Rank of 25 is 4P. Look at here. Rank of 25 is 4P and 16 is 6A. Okay. 25 is 4P. Right, 25 is 4P and 16 is 6A. That means 16 is not positioned at its at it do, in the step 5. 16th will be moved to its position in the 6th step. So therefore, you see that now if I have to check the position of the element 16, all you have to do is, after writing down the step 16, the position of 6B element is before 6A. So therefore, after 5B, it will be the number 11 and the number 16 that will be coming. Why I'm not arranging them? Because I'm supposed to find out the number of elements between 25 and 16 step 5. So till step 5, 16 will not be moved. 16 will be present at its own position. 11 will be present at its own position. So therefore, between 25 and 16, there will be 3 elements, right? And you can also write down what are those elements. You can see what is the rank of 5A, what is the rank of 5B. But we are supposed to tell only the number of elements. So the answer to the question is B, that is 3, right? Let's have a look at one more question. In step 6, if enough and major and 11 and 49 are interchanged, then how many elements will be placed between 49 and enough? So what is happening? Here what you are doing is, you are changing the position of enough and the major in step 6. Okay. And you are also changing the position of 11 and 49 in step 6. And then you are supposed to find out the number of elements which will be placed between 49 and enough. Right. Now you see that if I'm placing enough, if I'm changing enough and M, E and M, if I'm replacing the position of E and M and I'm replacing the position of 11 and 49, that means 49 will be coming in place of 11 and E will be coming in place of M. So if I'm supposed to find out the number of elements between E and 49, it will be same as the number of elements between M and 11. So all you have to do is just find out the rank of M and 11. So what is the rank of M? The rank of M here, you can see, is 5A. And the rank of 11 is 6B. So 5A and 6B. Now tell me, 5A and 6B, right? This is a 5A and this is 6B. What will happen after 5A? You will have the element 5B and then you will have 6A. So in the step 6, you see that between 5A and 6A, 5A and 6A, sorry, it's 11 is 16B. Let's look at the rank of 11. No, 11 is 16B, sorry. So 11 is 6B, right? Not 6A. So you see that between 5A and 6B, the number of elements will be 2. So therefore, the answer to the question is 2. That's the answer of the question. That's question number 9. Ranking will help you in answering these questions quickly without writing down all the steps. This is a ranking method, but you need to observe the movements of the element or the replacements of the element. In the previous set, we discussed the replacements of the elements, right? Where we were doing the ranking with there the movement was not happening. Elements were not moving on the left hand side, right? But here elements are positioned on the left hand side. So we are positioning them towards left. So we are ranking them like 1A, 1B, 2A, 2B, telling us that these are the elements moved in the leftmost position in the first step. These are the elements which are moved to the leftmost position in the second step and so on. This is the way to solve the input output question, guys. Thank you so much for joining the session. And this is my referral code LRDSME to subscribe to Unacademy Plus subscription as well as an Iconic subscription. There's an Iconic subscription that is going to start. Let me give you an overall idea on it. This is the question number 10 for this set, guys. Please try this question once by yourself, right? And cross-check your answer, right? Okay, this is the same question that we have just covered. This is the question, right? Question number 11, what is the position of 25 in step 4 from the right end? Very easy. In step 4, I'm supposed to tell the position of 25 from the right end, right? So all you have to see is the ranking of 25 and accordingly you can answer the question, right? So just try it once by yourself, right? I hope you will be able to do it very easily. All you have to do is see the rank of 25 from the right hand side, that's it. So guys, these are my upcoming courses for CAT 2021 that I will be studying in the month of January. So these are Arithmetic Without Formula 1000 question course, where I'll be discussing all the concepts of arithmetic without formulas, one step solution for algebra with 750 question course, comprehensive geometry course with 750 practice questions course, right? And you can also subscribe to Unacademy. You can also purchase Iconic membership, Iconic subscription for CAT 2021, where a personal mentor will be given to you to help you with all your strengths and weaknesses, and a test analysis and reports will be submitted to you. Other management and trust preparation will also be included under Iconic membership. All benefits of Plus will also be included. And there's a new feature that we have added to Unacademy Learning app, where you can just click a question, highlight that question that you want to ask, and you just send it to us. You will get your solution. This feature is available 24/7. Thank you so much for watching the video. Please refer to my code LRDISMIR to purchase Plus as well as the Iconic subscription. Thank you. See you in the next video.